Jess's dad, like, Luke goes to, like, tell Jess's dad to, like, leave town, and comes back, and, like, he tells, because Jess has never, like, met his dad, you know? And he's like, Luke goes to, he finds where he's staying, he's like, you gotta get out of here, like, Jess's life's really fucked up, you gotta, like, you can't really, like, I don't want you, like, fucking with him, because, like, you know, he knows him, and he knows that he's, like, a big fuck-up.
Mm-hmm.
And so, Jess's real dad doesn't listen to him and comes back and, like, tries to, like, talk to him, but, like, doesn't, and then, like, the last scene of the episode is, like, Rory and Jess are on a bus, and because they, like, haven't been talking because, like, that fight, mm-hmm. and
where?
It's, like, she's like, oh, hey, what's up? And Jess is just like, I can't take you to a prom. And she's like, oh, I gotta get off the bus. This is the episode that I almost cried at, actually.
Skip?
Yeah.
That's too bad, though.
It's a really sad episode.
Why is it sad?
Because, like, you see, like, Jess, like, has all his bags with him. He's, mm-hmm. like, leaving town, you know?
Why didn't you fully cry?
Because, oh, man.
Okay.
Where's the ladies' room? More coffee, please. Does Antonio Banderas live near here?
We do not know how to say, does Antonio Banderas live near here?
Oh, yes, what? We do. When we're in Spain, we need to know how to say, does Antonio Banderas live near here? When in France, does Johnny Depp live near here?
When in Rome, does Gore Vidal live near here?
You look like me, yet my ways are completely lost on you.
Lorelai,
come on, honey, put that down. You've been studying all day.
Can't put it down. I've got finals coming up.
I know you have finals coming up, but you also have a piece of pie sitting there that you've been completely ignoring.
Just let me get to the end of this chapter.
Fine. Do they do that?
Hey, how important do you think it is to be able to say, help, I'm bleeding from the head?
Just bring the phrase books.
No, if we learn all the phrases we need, then the phrase books are one less thing we have to lug around.
We will never be able to learn all the phrases in every language that we're going to need. Bring the books.
We can learn enough. Plus, doesn't everybody speak English over there anyway?
Like, ugly American, party of one.
Fine,
no,
bring the
like
books.
Tomato.
Okay, 5 minutes for pie.
Or like,
finally!
Like,
they're here. I've got them.
You got what?
The brochures from my college.
You seem chipper.
I am. I have decided to make this whole Seventh-day Adventist college experience a good one. I'm going to look on the bright side, find the silver lining, and make myself some lemonade.
Well, good for you.
The campus looks pretty.
Very pretty.
It's got two huge parks with gardens and lakes.
Two parks.
One for boys and one for girls.
Oh,
and you know, I had originally thought that this was going to be a suffocating place with out-of-date rules and insane restrictions, but boy, was I wrong. For example, curfew is up to 9:30. 9:45 if you're going for your master's. Makeup will be permitted as long as it identically matches your skin tone, and owning a Rolling Stone CD is no longer grounds for exposure. You can work the demerits off in the campus cleanup crew.
There's a separate park for boys.
My life is over.
Oh, I didn't say that.
You didn't have to. Well,
it is over.
It's not over.
Every kid in that brochure was awkward and panicked. It looked like the Academy Award audience during Michael Moore's speech.
Hey, why don't you add the phrase, just sit there and look pretty, to that list of yours there, okay? I gotta go back to sit.
Does that sexy guy in the Peugeot ad who had a bit part in Armageddon live near here?
If you're out on the road, feeling lonely and so awful,
I love that Lorelai doesn't cook.
She does.
She talks about it all the time. She's like, I don't cook. If you still have like a nice ass kitchen like that, after I'm gonna use it.
You scared me. Sorry. I've been sneaking around here like an idiot trying not to wake you up.
Been up for hours.
Why? Did you have a bad dream? The one where you finally meet Christiana Amanpour and she's really stupid?
I realized last night that at this rate I will never finish all the work I have to do.
What work?
What work? What work, she asks.
Well, you know, me and that Divi Christiana takes a little while to catch up.
Here.
Things to do before graduation. A list, of course. Study for finals, senior breakfast, senior awards, finish final edition of the Franklin, organize a new student government, convince Paris to give up student gavel.
Oh, and I forgot. Man the yearbook distribution table this afternoon at the stupid senior palooza. Unbelievable.
Well, I'll be manning the Booster Club grad night table at the same time, so we can feel stupid and abused together.
I can't finish all this and sleep at the same time.
You have to sleep. It's what keeps you pretty.
Who cares if I'm pretty if I fail my finals?
Oh, okay, you've got this so completely backwards. What is all this?
I found that if I focus too much on one subject, I start to get a little punchy. This way, when I hit Bolshevik Revolution Overload, I just shift over here, and oh, hello, Anne Boleyn is going down. And then when that gets too depressing, it's right over to calculus.
Saving the party subject for last, huh?
The shifting back and forth seems to produce better results.
I think you're pushing yourself too hard.
I made out a schedule. Every single moment of every single day from now until graduation is accounted for.
You left off the Kiwanis luncheon.
I did? Mm-hmm. Are you sure?
It's on Monday.
How could I forget the Kiwanis luncheon? They gave me their scholarship.
Oh, yes. $250 scholarship. That'll keep you in microwave popcorn for a week.
I'll just have to move something around, and I'll have to work Grandma in.
Excuse me?
Grandma called and asked if I could come over and help her pick out a dress to wear to my graduation.
No.
I have to.
Right, my mother's been dressing herself for years, and she has yet to show up at a function with her bra on the outside of her clothing.
She asked. I can't say no.
Tell her about the koala bears. She'll understand.
Please stop making fun of them. We need every cent we can get. Yale is expensive.
I know Yale is expensive.
Well, we haven't heard from Yale Financial Aid yet.
We will. Relax.
Well, we'd better hear from them soon because I have a deposit to send in for my room, and I have a bunch of supplies to buy, and I want to get all of that out of the way before we go to Europe. Otherwise, I'll be obsessing about it the entire time.
Okay. Listen, I'm going to go out and get the paper.
Okay, well, don't show it to me because I have no time for recreational reading until June.
Hey, could we move your chill session from 4 o'clock tomorrow afternoon to right now? That'd be great. Thanks.
Rory is not a chair.
Okay, little tip. The whole stalking thing works infinitely better when you don't actually smash your face in the window.
I need to talk to you.
Well, come inside.
No, Shamari's in there.
Since when are you scared of Rory? Because seriously, Luke, I think you can take her.
I just need to tell you something. Can she hear us?
Through the walls? No, I put some kryptonite in her waffles. We're good.
Come over here.
You're freaking out to freaks this morning.
Jess is gone.
What?
And I don't think he's coming back.
What do you mean, gone? Like gone, gone?
Exactly like gone, gone.
But when?
Yeah.
Last night, this morning, I don't know. I went up there to get some money out of the safe, and I noticed that all of his stuff was gone.
Oh, Luke, I'm so sorry.
Yeah, well, forget it. I'm through with him. He's 18. He can do whatever the hell he wants. He's on his own. I'm through.
Luke.
No, it's a relief. That kid was driving me crazy. Let him make his own way from now on. Let him see how far that smart mouth of his gets him without someone watching his back. I couldn't be more relieved. I'm just worried about Rory. I assume she doesn't know.
She hasn't said anything.
I can tell her if you want me to.
No, it's okay. I can do it. I just have to figure out when. She's got a lot of things on her mind right now.
Well, don't wait too long. She'll notice eventually.
Yes. Okay. Well, thanks for coming over.
Why is she lying? He's such a fucking scumball. Who? Lorelai? Oh no, Jess.
I failed him.
You did not fail him. You supported him. You defended him. You gave him a chance. And if he chose not to take it, there's nothing more you could do.
Yeah.
What?
Well,
who?
I should go.
Jess?
Do you have any idea where he went?
Like,
I got a pretty good idea.
Came because he comes from a fucked up family and there's not because the town has like 15 people.
Hey! There is no chill time scheduled for 4 o'clock tomorrow, and the one thing I really don't have time for are your jokes, Missy.
Later's good.
What? 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 I want to see what Jess is doing here in the big city. We got New York. Oh no, he went to California.
That's a long ride.
That would take like a week. Yeah. Did
you need some help,
friend? Nope. After 25 years, I can certainly point you in a direction to make your journey easier. Enjoy this beautiful day.
Fucking asshole.
How the alfalfa sprouts and potato mashed yeast.
Catch a wave and you're sitting on top of the world.
Why are you
be afraid to drive the grain and sport around? Catch a wave. Catch a wave. Those who don't just have to put it down.
Dude, what did that go? Wait, why are those girls have like identical pink hands? Gilmore. Gary Gilmore. Dude. I wonder if this show is like the reason that there's like every commercial has music like this now. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Yes, I've been holding for Mr. Hennings. I'm Lorelei Gilmore. Oh, great. Hi, listen. I just received this letter saying that my daughter did not qualify for financial aid. Lori Gilmore,